Let's make space personal for you and you and you and you and you and you. It's easy. Just connect with your mobile phone to your own personal nanosatellite. Simple. No big deal. Living as we do in the 21st century, we all have the mandate of pushing the limitations of technology and of scientific breakthrough to the adjacent possible. And that means that boundaries grow as we explore them. And this whole new possibility of space opens new dimensions for us. And that's why we really have the idea to instantly connect you all to space. And we have identified the following five key points of personalization, because we believe space and personalization is really a human experience. So number one, you will have instant access to your own nanosatellite. Number two, you will have ownership of the nanosatellite, so it means you can buy it. Number three, we image an unprecedented large area coverage. Number four, the applications that you will be able to access, they will be related to your own personal life and to your personal situation. And perhaps the most important point is number five, that you will get motivation, feelings, excitement as you can view the Earth from space. And we believe that that your mobile phone is the key tool to connect to space. So we have the motto that the mobile phone is your direct interface to space. Or maybe is there anyone in the audience who does not have a mobile phone? Okay, great. You all have mobile phones. So you and the other 7.1 billion people on planet Earth, they can all be connected to space. Since in 2014, the number of mobile phones is supposed to exceed the world's population because there's really an explosion of mobile phones. So that's really amazing. That's why we have the plan to make space personal for you to install a constellation of 88 nanosatellites for Earth imaging. And actually, the conventional satellites for communication, they are the size of a school bus, so that's about a half of this room. So you really see the difference between that and this nanosatellite. And we believe that this nanosatellites are the new sci-tech of space systems that is enabled by the miniaturization of micro components and also commercial off-the-shelf components. So we can use the components in this phone actually in this one-on-one model. And actually, space is very close to us. It just starts at 100 kilometers. That's where the Kármán line is. So that is the boundary between the Earth's atmosphere and outer space. And this constellation will be operating between 200 and 400 kilometers altitude. So that's quite low and actually very close to the Earth. And it will enable novel applications like augmented reality, but also improve traditional applications like forest fire monitoring. And I want to give you a prototype application. So for example, with the data that the satellite generates, we can make a 3D temperature map of Australia, and we can locally find the temperatures. And once the temperature hits 300 degrees Celsius, that's when wood starts to burst into flames. So it looks like this. Then actually there can be sent an instant alert to the fire brigade, and they can see on their mobile phones that immediately they have to go and extinguish the fire. But also you yourself can see on your phone, this is where the fire is, and this is how far it's reaching, or maybe where are my loved ones. And also just 3 days ago, I went to Perth, Western Australia, and there I heard that in Netherlands was this Stormageddon, like this gigantic storm. And yeah, and I would have loved to check on my phone, like maybe my car, was it safe, or maybe some tree fell into it. So this could also be an application. But the biggest application that is possible, I believe, is augmented reality. So you could imagine that you would be at the most exciting places virtually present. So you could go on a safari, or you could go mountaineering. So you could imagine you could climb the highest mountains virtually, like Mount Everest. And this is Patrick Hollingworth. I met him in Australia just 4 days ago, and he actually climbed Mount Everest. And it would be of great value to make a virtual climb actually before the real climb, to prepare for the real expedition, such that you can really optimize your choices and are not immediately on the border of life or death, because the pressure on the mountain is just 1/3 of Earth's atmosphere. And that's why this 88 nanosatellite constellation will change your view of the Earth, and it will give you an executive power on to be at any place, at any time, present. And we have really confirmed this vision with an astronaut. So this is Leroy Chow, and he spent 229 days in space. And I met him at the International Astronautical Congress. It was 3 weeks ago. This was in Beijing, in China. And he wrote like a personal message, especially for this audience, confirming this vision. And he would really like you to experience the same as he did in space. So the experience of spaceflight is a life-changing event. And the view of the Earth from low Earth orbit is what leaves the biggest impression. During one of my spacewalks, I was facing straight down. I had no view of the spacecraft, so I felt like a satellite flying over the Earth. While I was watching the continents and oceans roll by, I was struck by the beauty and peace instilled. If all world leaders could have this experience, maybe we would have less conflict on our planet. So this is my call today, really, to this audience to join the new race for space. Thank you.